Hello everyone, let's look at more trig equations today. This time we are going to look at a trig equation that's in quadratic form. Why do I say that it's in the quadratic form? Because if we treat sine x as a variable, then we are having a square on the sine x. And so in that case, we have a quadratic term and we have also a linear term because the power for the sine x is the first power. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is to just ask ourselves, what kind of form do we have for this equation? Let's say if I replace this sine x with a different variable, then what does it look like? What does the equation look like? The equation actually looks like this. We have a 2y squared and then minus y, and that's equal to 1. And then what is y here? The y is actually our sine x. And so let me just label the y in a different color so as it becomes, if we replace it back with the sine x, then we get back to the original equation. Okay, so it's actually the same equation except that we are now looking at y as the variable instead of the sine x. Okay, so now how do we solve this quadratic equation here? One way to do it is to just factor it, or we can try to use the quadratic formula. And before we do that, then we actually need to get everything on one side of the equation, and then we have zero on the other side of the equation. So if we do that, then we are going to get the equation into 2 and then the y, right? And then we have the square and then minus the y, right? That's the still the sine x, and then we subtract the 1 from both sides, right? So we are going to get minus 1, and that's equal to 0. So this equation right here actually can be factored. So if we factor this equation, we are going to, let's just take a look here. So if we factor this equation, then we are going to get a product of two binomials. One of them is going to be 2y, right? 2y. And the other one will just be the y. Okay, so see what's going on here. We take the 2y times the y. We are going to get 2y squared. And then now we look at the constant term. For this constant term, we need to figure out two numbers that we multiply. And we are getting this number. And that will be obvious, right? Because to get 1, we just need to multiply 1 and the 1 so that we can get this one here. And then we need to worry about the sign, of course. Let's think about the middle term. The middle term is negative y. And so in order for us to get a negative sign in the middle term, we need to have the 2y times the 1, which is the 2y, to have a negative sign. So we need to put a minus sign at this spot right here. So this spot will be a minus sign. And then what about the sign here? We are going to get a positive 1y so that when we add to the negative 2y, then we can get this negative y. So we are going to get a positive sign here for our factorization. Okay, so the left hand side of this equation is already factored. So now going back to the equation, we can actually follow the same process that we were doing here. We're solving this equation, so we can actually move the 1 over, right? We move the 1 over. And then minus sine x and minus 1, and that is equal to 0. And in fact, because we already have done the work, then we actually don't need to do too much. We can actually just write down the factorization here. So we are getting 2, and then the y is the sine x, right? We are going to replace the y with the sine x. And then what do we get here? We're going to get the plus. So we are going to get 2 times the sine x plus 1. And then the other factor would be the sine x also. And then minus 1. And that's equal to 0. So now we have two numbers. This is one number, 2 sine x plus 1 is one number, and the other number is sine x minus 1. When we multiply them, we are going to get 0. So that means according to the zero product property, that really means that one of the numbers, at least one of the numbers, has to be zero. So either the 2 sine x plus 1 is equal to zero, or the sine x minus 1 must be equal to zero. So in that case, we can continue to solve our equation by writing down the two cases. First case is that the first factor, the 2 sine x plus 1, is equal to zero. And then, or the other case would be the sine x and then minus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, in fact, we can actually just draw a line to in the middle to separate our work so that they don't get into each other's way. Okay, so that's good. Now, let's solve this equation here. This becomes a linear equation, and to solve it, we are going to isolate the sine x. So what we need to do is to move the 1 over and then divide by 2. Then we are getting sine x with the 2 in the front, and that's equal to negative 1. And then you divide by 2, then you are going to get sine x is equal to negative 1 over 2. And actually, that space is unnecessary, so let me move it closer. No problem. Yeah, so it tells you that sine x is equal to negative 1 over 2. In this case, we just need to write down the reference angle. And for the reference angle, we can actually just construct a right triangle on the side to do our scratch work. So let's do that. Let's construct a right triangle on the side. Okay. And then this is, again, this is the angle that we are looking at. If you have watched my other videos, then I actually have been doing this for a few times already. So for sine is opposite over the hypotenuse. So opposite is going to be 1, and then the hypotenuse is going to be 2. And then, of course, the adjacent will be the square root of 3. Now, regarding this negative sign right here, we actually don't need to worry about it when we are constructing this angle, because we are just trying to figure out the reference angle. So from here, as you can see, the reference angle, it's actually facing this one right here. And so the angle for 30, 60, 90 degree right triangle, the angle that's facing the one is the 30 degree angle. So that one is 30 degree. And so we can actually write down our reference angle. The reference angle would be 30 degree right here. Then you may say, what about the quadrants? The quadrants are in a different situation here. The quadrants, just draw this sine chart right here. That will help us figure out the answer, which is A, S, T, C. Okay, now, it tells you that sine is positive in the first quadrant and then also in the second quadrant. So that means sine will be negative in the third quadrant and then the fourth quadrant from this chart. And so we can actually write down the result. We have the quadrant. The quadrant would be 3 and then 4. Okay. And so right now we are going to write down the final answer based on the reference angle and then the quadrants. And so in this case, we can write down the solution. The solution for just this portion of the, just for this equation, is that I want an angle in the third quadrant with a reference angle of 30 degree. And so that would be 210, which is 7 pi over 6. So I can actually label that right here. That's 210 degree. That's actually just adding 30 degree to the 180 degree to obtain this angle. And then you may say, what about the other one? The other one is the angle that's in the quadrant 4. And for an angle in the quadrant 4, all we need to do is to take the 360 minus the 30. Then we are going to get 330. And that, if written radian, it would be 11 pi over 6. And so the angle is 330 degree. Okay. So that's good. And then you may say, what about this side? This side, it's another case, right? Now we need to worry about the other case. And just like usual, we need to first isolate the sine function. So we are going to get sine x is equal to 1 because we're adding 1 to both sides to get rid of this negative 1 on the left side. Okay, so sine x equals 1 tells us that we are having an angle that's quadrennial. So for quadrennial angle, then we are going to, what do we get for a quadrennial angle? First, let's just recall something here. So let's recall. We're getting the sine if we're putting the point on the unit circle, then sine theta is equal to, now again, we may be having variable conflict if we put x right here, and then there is also we put x, y, or r on the right-hand side. So I'm just going to use theta here. Okay, so what is that? Sine theta is going to be equal to, what is that? That's the y value, okay? So that's the y value over the r. But remember that if it's on a unit circle, then we actually can just substitute 1 into the r. So we are just going to get the y value of the point. And so that's really just saying that the x value will be 0 in this case. So the point that we are looking at that's lying on the terminal side of the angle would be 0, 1. And so where is 0, 1 located? 0, 1 is actually located on the positive y-axis, as you can see. So if we just draw an xy plane right here, just draw a tiny sketch with the xy plane, where is this point? This point is actually lying at this location right here. Okay, so that's 0, 1. Yeah, so what is that angle? That angle is actually pi over 2, that's 90 degrees. Okay. So that's all the solutions that we get for the angle on this interval from 0 to 2 pi. And yeah, so I will just draw this line longer so that it will separate the two sides from each other. Okay. Yeah, so whenever you run into this kind of equations in the quadratic form, then usually you just need to solve the quadratic equation and then you can figure out the answers from there. And yeah, so that's it for this problem. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and give me some support. Thank you for watching this video.